she basically lied on the stand, and we had proof to show that she lied, and the judge would not let that proof come in.
What was that proof?
We had documents, well, at one point in the beginning, I don't know if you recall, but she was talking about contacting Vernon, and at one point, Pete Kennedy had written a letter in response to some of the inquiries from DATCAP, and she basically said, no, I received no response.
Right.
But we had a letter.
Yeah, she not only said that, she said she hadn't received, she received no response from him.
Right, right. And that was a lie. And it was, for me, to see the lie happen, and then the ability to say, wait a minute, we need to show that lie. Mr. Reynolds, Glenn Reynolds, did a great job of attempting to make that impeachment happen, and the judge just would not allow it, which is, for again, for me, it was one of those moments where I was just knew that there is inappropriate decision making in that courtroom. So I hate saying that because I have such respect for the courts and judges. So to see that was just really saddening. Because the fairness involved in hiding information from the jury, and unfortunately, that's the theme of this. It's a shell game, and they want to hide the truth. So
yeah, let's
move on from that.
Let's move on to the cross examination.
Yeah.
And
so the cross examination was exciting.
Yeah, the cross examination I thought was fascinating and quite dramatic.
And
maybe you can fill us in a little bit with kind of what's the strategy in that situation. You have a witness who's obviously very well prepared and very articulate.
Well, 6 years of preparation.
Yeah, well, not only that, but she's a smart woman, and she was coached very heavily.
Prepped.
And so, you know, she went in there a lot better prepared than that guy, Mitch Lohr.
And I do want to say one thing, and because it does go to the defense, but it came out so strikingly today that the mindset of DATCAP was already made up. So in essence, when they sent interrogatories questioning Vernon to reveal his association agreements and some questions about how the farm was run, you could see, for me, it glared of entrapment. I mean, you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. So if you answer, you're telling the truth, and Vernon's gonna tell the truth. But then you're revealing how this is going. And then on the flip side of that, if you don't respond, then now we're at the point where we're in trial. And even at that point, there were responses made, but DATCAP considered them unresponsive. And basically, when I've dealt with any kind of investigation, investigators want to see the whole picture. And that's just not what happened here. There were blinders put on, and unfortunately, we're at this point today because the truth is being hidden from the people. So because we only had one witness today, if you guys have questions, please feel free to come up and ask anything, but we want to keep it a little bit short today because, you know,
It's been a long day, I don't know what else.
And there's really, and other than this one witness, that's pretty much what we're covering. So there was some information where this witness had drafted a complaint of 42 counts that were the initial attempts to